taught you to hate the shape of your nose and the shape of your lips? Who taught you to hate yourself from the top of your head?
I used to go to Brandeis on 84th Street. And I'm in high school and I'm just minding my business. I remember that it used to be like, everybody used to be in separate groups. Like it would be like the Dominican group, the Puerto Rican group, the Black people group. It would be like their own group. It was nobody, like nowadays I see everybody that is talking, they having fun, and they all together. That's not how it's. So I'm walking in the hallway, I'm about to go to my English class. And this Black girl just come and say something to me, and I turned around and looked at her. And she just, for no reason, came back between her and some lesbian girl, jumped me. Started punching me in the face, hit me a lot, whatever. They kicked me, they did whatever they did to me. But eventually, it turned out to be that I was like the worst out of everybody in the school because I used to be bullying others in school. Spit on people's face, push them for no reason, just because I was feeling that, like that. And you know, one day I felt so bad for one girl because it was just that I just didn't like her. Like I pushed her in the hallway, I spit on her face, I cursed her out, called her out to fight. She never did nothing. She was like just there.
I was in the seventh grade, and I was pretty new to the school, and this guy bullied me for no reason. He called me Beetlejuice, and I didn't understand why. I was nice to everybody there, and nobody would defend me, because nobody liked me in the school. Before, I felt like I didn't have any confidence. I felt so dead inside, and I just wanted to. I didn't know what to do. I became a bully myself. I started bullying sixth graders. I felt like I needed to do it back to somebody else because I knew how. I wanted them to feel how it felt to me. I actually got suspended this one time. I was in a dance class in eighth grade. And there was this little girl, and I did not like her at all. And she was just staring at me for no reason. So I go up to her. I go, "I don't like you. Why are you looking at me?" And she, that same day, she ran to the guidance counselor, and she told on me, and I got suspended because I was bullying. It affected me mentally, physically. Mentally, because I didn't want to talk to anybody. And all I just thought for myself, oh my God, I'm ugly. I need to stay to myself. I don't want nobody to pick on me. And like, I would just cry to myself because I didn't know what to do anymore. And then physically, I wanted to be by myself. I didn't want to go to school when I was in seventh grade. And just thinking about me to cry.
In the eighth grade, I was bullied like every day. I cried every day. Like, people called me ugly. I don't know, I'm always nice to people. Like, I'm never mean to anybody. Like, I don't curse anybody out. But I guess people that are nice get bullied the worst. Just to think about what they've called me and what they said, like, it still affects me. I'm self-conscious about what, how I dress, how I look, how, like, a person sees me. Like, I don't know. I care too much. Sometimes I think I care too much. And it kind of hurts when I hear somebody say something, because then I obviously think I have to change, or I gotta do something better to make somebody like me or something. And I know I shouldn't care about that, but I do.
not just something that happens in a school or something that teenagers go through. It's something that everybody goes through. It's something that little kids, babies go through. Something that toddlers go through. Something that kids go through. Something that teenagers go through. And something that grown-ups go through.
Hey there, sad eyes, what's on your mind? Don't look so down, give it some time. You don't have to be